Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Woo! Hallelujah. 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 Oh, glory, 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 glory. Glory, 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 glory. Glory, glory, glory. Let your Shekinah glory shine on us today, God. Let your Shekinah glory. Let your Shekinah glory. Your Shekinah glory shine on us today, Lord. Shine on us. Shine on us. Shine on us. Let your Shekinah glory shine on us. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. It is so. It is so. It is so. It is so. Oh, you got to say it like you believe it. It is so. It is so. Ah, it is so. It is so. It is so. Hey, there's peace in my home. It is so. It is so. Peace in my home. It is so. It is so. Ah, it is so. Hey, a way maker. It is so. Ooh, healing in my body. It is so. It is so. Hey. Ah, ha, ha, ha. Hey, 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 hey. Ah, ha, ha, ha. It is so. It is so.
Amen. At this time, if you remain standing, we'll have our scripture reading from Psalms 91. So he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in him will I trust. Surely he shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. He shall cover thee with his feathers, and under his wings shall thy trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler. Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor the arrow that fly by day, not for the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor for the destruction that wasteth at noonday. 1,000 shall fall at their side, and 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come nigh thee. Only with thine eyes shall thou behold and see the reward of the wicked, because thou hast made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, thy habitation. There shall no evil befall thee, neither shall any plague come nigh thy dwelling. For he shall give his angels charge over thee to keep thee in all thy ways. They shall bear thee up in their hands, lest thou dash thy foot against a stone. Thou shalt tread upon the lion and adder. The young lion and the dragon shall thy trample under feet. Because he hath set his love upon me, therefore will I deliver him. I will set him on high because he hath known my name. He shall call upon me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. With long life will I satisfy him and show him my salvation. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading and hearing of his word.
You would remain standing. We are going to go through our affirmation of faith. It's going to be on the screen, and I'll be reading the leader, and if you would read the congregation. We affirm our faith in the Bible. We affirm our faith in God. We affirm our faith in the blessed hope. We We affirm our faith in repentance. We affirm our faith in salvation. We affirm our faith in Jesus Christ. We affirm our faith in the Holy Spirit. We affirm our faith in sanctification. Amen. In this we do believe. Thank you.
For me, oh, you extended your everlasting mercy, so daily I shall worship thee. Hey, how many feel like worshiping? Daily I shall worship thee. God, your mercy, so daily I shall, every day I shall, long as I've got life in my body, I shall worship thee. Come on, give God praise. If you're here to worship him, come on and tell him thank you. If you're here to worship the Lord, tell him thank you. Give him the fruit of your lips today. We give God glory and we worship him every day, daily. We worship the Lord. And it's real easy to do that. You know why? Because daily he loaded us with his benefits. We can't outpraise him. We can't outgive him. We can't outbless him because he just keeps on doing it. Over and over again, he keeps blessing us, and he daily loads us with his benefits. Today is Women's Day. Amen. It is Women's Day, and I praise God. One of my children, many, many years ago, I can't remember which one of my girls, but when they were real little, they said, "Ooh, it's Women's Day. This is a big deal." Yes, it's a big deal, and it's always been a big deal. Women's Day at Greater Holy Temple has always been a big deal. And so we praise God today for how he blessed us. And today we are worshiping the Lord in the beauty of holiness. And our women are going forth. We want to give honor to our pastor today. And we thank him, thank the Lord for our first lady, all of the people of God, our elders, our church mother, each one of you, all of our visitors today. We are blessed and highly favored of the Lord to be here. We want you to enjoy the service today, enjoy the Lord, enjoy his presence, because already I'm feeling a stirring. We've got a great messenger coming, but I tell you already, I'm feeling a stirring. I don't know, I've got a feeling today. I've got some expectation. I feel, you know what I'm feeling today? I'm feeling, hit that bass for me. Just give me a bass run. Yeah, that's how I'm feeling today. Come on. Come on. Yeah. Yeah, that's what I'm feeling today. I'm down. That's it. I feel it just like that. That's how I'm feeling today. I'm feeling it just like that. Yes, God. Oh, my. I got some expectation. I don't know. Yeah, God, I feel it just like that today. Thank God. Thank God. Y'all sit down because, see, y'all trying to trick me, and I'm not falling for it. Y'all trying to trick me, but I'm not falling for it. Yeah, y'all sit down. Sit down. Sit down. Well, if you ain't gonna sit down, you might as well dance. If you ain't gonna sit down, you might as well go on and have church. Sit down. Praise. Well, if you ain't gonna sit down, you might as well dance. Today for how he has blessed us, and today we are here and we have a spirit of expectation. It's just a spirit of expectation. I feel it. I felt it when I got up this morning. I've already been in one service today. I just come for some more at our annual Women's Day service. We're blessed, and I'm going to get out of your way. Glad to see Marie. Ain't seen Marie in years. Look at God. I know she had moved away, but she's here. with us on today, and others of you, our guests, we are blessed and highly favored. I'm going to carry on. We don't want to get, you know, go backward today. I know traditionally, you know, what we normally do. See, you know what, and I'm true. You know what, we've been trying to get away from church as usual. Is that right or wrong? Amen. What we want the Lord to do is have his way. And so normally, you know, we shout later. You know, usually we hold our shouting until later on. But, you know. But if, you know, if y'all want to shout at the beginning, that's all right, too. We can just dance anytime because the Lord is just good to us. We're going to carry on, though. We're going to move on. Thank God. Thank God for already blessing in the service. I feel his presence, and we're going to feel it some more. But we're going to move on at this time. Thank God we've got a guest worship leader today. And we're going to say amen to her at this time. Sister Yolanda, come on now. And we're going to just ask God to just bless us. Let's say amen for her as she comes. Sister Yolanda Ash is coming to lead us in praise and worship. God, you got that. Yes. Thank God. God bless
amen.
You.
God bless you. Amen. God bless you. Amen. I'm just so honored to be here. Amen. To be a part of this. And I'm no stranger because I'm saved. I'm sanctified and I'm filled with the precious gift of the Holy Ghost. My name is Missionary Yolanda Ash, and I am a member of Pentecostal Cathedral. Bishop Alford is my pastor. And I just thank God for being here today because I felt his presence when she was praying. I felt the presence of the Lord. So I know the presence of the Lord is here. Amen. Amen. So you're not going to be spectators and watch me. I heard she said this was praise and worship. So this is corporate praise and worship so you can join in. Amen. Amen. And I just love the Lord. How many love the Lord today? How many love the Lord? Do you truly love him? Are you sold out to him? Amen. I was driving in my car the other day and I was just riding and I just put my hand out the window and said, Lord, I love you. Lord, I love you. And that's all I kept saying, and the tears just started rolling down. Lord, I love you, because he's been so good to us. Even when we were unlovable, he's been good to us. Amen. Hallelujah. So we're going to stand and we're going to sing I love you, Lord, today. Amen. We're going to do a few worship medleys and praise and worship medleys to get you in the spirit, because if you're not in it already, shame on you, because I felt already here. Amen. Amen, amen. I can't hear you. Do you love him? Amen. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I love you. I love you. I love you, Lord, today. Let's worship him. Because you cared for me in such a special way. And yes, I'll praise you. I'll lift you up and I'll magnify your name. That's why my heart is filled with praise. Help me say, I love you, Lord. I love you. Hallelujah. I love you. I love you, Lord. I love you, Lord, today, because you care for me. Hallelujah. Let me hear you in such a special way. Hallelujah. And yes, I'll praise you. I'll lift you up and I'll magnify your name. That's why my heart is filled with praise. Do you have that in your spirit? Help me say, I love you, Lord. I love you. Yes, I love you. I love you, Lord. I love you, Lord, today, because you care for me. Because you cared for me in such a special way. Hallelujah. And yes, I'll praise you. I'll praise you. I'll lift you up and I'll magnify your name. That's why my heart is filled with praise. My heart, my mind, my soul belongs to you. Yes, it does. You paid the price for me. Think about it way back on Calvary. And yes, I'll praise you. I'll lift you up and I'll magnify your name. That's why my heart is filled with praise. Help me say my heart, my mind, my soul. My soul belongs to you. You paid the price. Hallelujah. Way back on Calvary. And yes, I'll praise you. I'll lift you up. Why my heart is filled. Hallelujah, think about it. That's why my heart is filled with praise. Why my heart is filled with praise. That's why, oh, that's why my heart. Is your heart filled with praise today? Tell them my heart. That's why my heart is filled. One more time, tell the Lord. That's why my heart is filled with praise. My heart is filled. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Worship the Lord right there. That's a good place to worship Him because of who He is. Amen. Hallelujah. We worship Him today. He's the living, true God. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We worship you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I love you, Jesus. Hallelujah. I worship and adore you. Hallelujah. Yes, sing it. Lord, I love you. Hallelujah, more than. Hallelujah, tell them you love them. I love you, Jesus. Hallelujah, I worship you. I worship you. Hallelujah, I just want to tell you. Jesus, lift your voices, let them hear you, Lord. Hallelujah. I worship and adore you. Just want to tell you, Lord, I love you. Lord, I love you more than anything. I love you, Jesus. I worship. Hallelujah. Just want to tell you, Lord, I love you. Lord, I love you more. One more time, tell them I love you. I love you, Jesus. Hallelujah. I worship and adore you. Give him a hand clap of praise if you love him. Hallelujah. I love him. I don't know about you, but I love him. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So we worship him. Amen. And the words say worship him in spirit and in truth. But we're going to praise him. So we know that you can praise him. Everybody may not be able to worship him. Everybody may not give him the glory, but you should be able to give him praise for waking you up this morning, for starting you on your way. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I'm a soldier. 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 I got my war clothes on. Hallelujah. I got my war clothes on. I got my war clothes on. My war clothes on. If I die, let me die. 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 Oh, God is a good God. Oh, God is a good God. God. Oh, my God is a good God. Yes, he is. 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 There's a storm out on the ocean, and it's moving this old way. If your soul's not anchored in Jesus, you will surely drift away. There's a storm out on the ocean, and it's moving this old way. If your soul's not anchored in Jesus, you will surely drift away. Drift away, drift away. You will surely drift away. If your soul's not anchored in Jesus, you will surely drift away. Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Everybody ought to get up. 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 To be praised. He is worthy to be praised. He is worthy to be praised. He is worthy to be praised. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. For his goodness, for his mercy, for his grace, for his love. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord. In the morning, praise the Lord. In the noonday, praise the Lord. In the evening, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. He is worthy. He is worthy. He is worthy. He is worthy. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Yes. Hallelujah. How many you know he's worthy. He's worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. For his goodness. Praise the Lord. For his mercy. Praise the Lord. 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 Hallelujah! 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 I can't help but praise him. Hallelujah! I had COVID when I didn't even know what it was. But I stand here today and I'm able to praise him. Hallelujah! Thank you, Jesus. Glory! Praise the Lord! Praise the Lord. 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 Praise the Lord.
And we are here today, and we came to enjoy Jesus and the Holy Ghost. Yeah, God and the Lord has already met us in this place. Thank God for that great praise service from the woman of God, how she shared about loving the Lord, just giving him praise. This is what we came for, and we are so glad the Lord has already met us. We've already felt the presence of the Lord. Yeah, God, because this is what we came for. And we are certainly glad for the Lord, how the Lord has blessed us already in our Women's Day service. We want to appreciate and thank God for our Superintendent Hackworth coming in, along with his lovely wife, who just happens to be our speaker for this afternoon. Let's give them a real good applause. Amen. We thank God for them, along with their District Missionary Betty Holliday. We are blessed today. Thank God for the people of God. Thank God for all of our visitors. Seem like I see quite a few wards in the house today. I let somebody say amen for the wards here today. Yes, God. And for our other guests, and Sister Eva Turner, and also Sister Ruth Mack is coming at this time. She's going to be welcoming our visitors. And after she's finished, Sister Eva Turner is going to come and share this great occasion with you. Let's receive them.
Amen.
I want to give honor to God today and say hello to everybody. Hello. Praise the Lord. I got a question to ask you before I move on. Do you feel welcome? You feel welcome? Then I don't have to say much. We praise the Lord for his presence here today in my life. And I believe this is our first official Women's Day in August. We always had it in February. And so some of us ladies got tired of the winter time and the men had the good time weather. So we decided to switch up for a little bit. And so we thank the Lord for August and our first Women's Day in August. I do praise God for being here because without God, none of us would be here. We honor our pastor, Pastor Ross, Lady Ross. Amen. You can clap. Superintendent Hackworth and his lady, Evangelist Kina Hackworth. And you know, all the rest of you visiting churches, somebody invited you, didn't they? Most of you just didn't walk in here and sit down and feel at home, but somebody said, we're having the Women's Day, would you come? Or we sent a letter to your church or to your pastor or somebody. You know why? Because we wanted you. We wanted you to be here today. We wanted you to come and praise the Lord with us. And so we want to make you comfortable. Even though with the mask on, some of you I probably didn't even recognize. But I tried to smile so you could see the cheekbones and the eyes. And you can tell when a person is smiling by their eyes. Even under a mask, you can tell if a person's mean. So we're smiling today at you because we're so glad that you came. Memorial Hospital has a greeting, and I don't know if they still have it. I haven't been out there for a while. But if you call out there and ask for a patient, they would say what? My pleasure. And then they would say, my pleasure. You say, may I have this extension? My pleasure. And that made you feel good already because they wanted to do that for you. Like, we want you to be here today. So it's our pleasure to have you here today. We want you to be comfortable. When you invite somebody into your home, you don't just ignore them and don't give them any water, don't let them do anything. They got to sit like in a nutshell, you know, scared to move. But you say, be comfortable, take your shoes off, relax yourself. Now, you've already done this, so I don't have to really say all this because we've already shouted. No doubt some of you have taken your shoes off. And we've already had a good time in the Lord. That's what we came for. So, on behalf of these ladies that's in charge today, who is Mother Jean Kane, Sister Gail Dukes, Sister Sarita Turner, Sister Eileen Williams, on their behalf and the behalf of the pastor and Lady Ross and the rest of us, we're saying welcome. We're glad you came. Spanish people has a saying, well, when I was in Spanish class 50 years ago or so, and I almost forgot everything I knew, Sister Gloria. But we would say, mi casa es su casa. Yeah. My house is your house. So I'm saying, mi iglesia es su iglesia. My church is your church. Enjoy the Lord.
Occasion and the house has already been addressed, and I'm the occasion is not on.
Yeah.
Okay. And now I have to start over. You're comfortable, and I'm nervous. And I, the house has already been addressed, and I also, you know, and the occasion that I came to do, and Mother Harris, this is a little bit off of tradition, but it's still going to be an occasion. And what the occasion is the annual Women's Day celebration. We celebrate Greater Holy Temple Women. And the topic that I chose just to incorporate with the occasion, Precious Jewels Among Us. And I chose a scripture, Proverbs 31 and 30. And it reads as follows: charm is deceitful, and beauty is passing, but a woman who fears the Lord shall be praised. And that's the scripture. And I still got a little bit more. Now I'm getting a little bit more calm now, so I can talk now. And just a little history of background. I like to put history when it comes down to occasion in our church, so people know where they see where we're at, but I would like for them to know where we came from. The history background is the annual women's celebration began under Pastor Leroy Sutton and First Lady Helen Sutton. Their home was the first meeting place of the women. And she felt, Helen Sutton felt that the home setting would be more comfortable for the ladies to bond. And it was not just for the Greater Holy Temple women. It was for anybody that wanted to come, because two of our church members, Mother Marion Kane was one of them that came through the YWCC, and one of them is no longer with us, but Deborah Grimes came through that as well. And so when you have something for the church, for the women, bind together, it helps all over. When the women are satisfied, everybody's satisfied. I heard that before somewhere else. And on the behalf of the women's department, I think this was said before, but it does bear repeating, the YWCC and the CWC and the missionaries, our purpose is to be a cornerstone and a building block for holy, godly women, and to be an influence to all the women seeking to become holy and godly. And I also have a special, and I thought this would be fitting because there's a lot of women because I've been through Greater Holy Temple with my grandmother in history way back, and I remember a lot of these women, and a lot of these women are no longer with us, but I thought it would be fitting today. There's a lot of relatives of some of these women, and I would just like to acknowledge their presence that they were once with us. And I will start out with First Lady Betty Wilson, First Lady Viola Wiley, First Lady Helen Sutton, Mother Corrine Blackman, Sister Linda D. Berry, and I hope I pronounce her name, my Sister Leslie Fannin, and Sister Lucia Gladney, and Mother Goldie Ivory, Mother Ella Jones, Sister Rosie Mathis, Mother McCurry, Mother Marion Moore, Mother Florence Nickerson, and Mother Josephine Redding, Mother Julia Redding, Mother Ida Sperling, Sister Dorothy Powell, Sister Idine Ward, and Mother Clara Wilson. And I have one more, so I'll close this with a little humor. There was also a granddaughter of Mother Redding and a niece of Mother Dry. She used to come to the church, you know, quite frequently. And she used to sit way back on this other side, and she was real fond of Pastor Sutton. That was her buddy. And she was here at Annual Women's Day, and she didn't know what was going on. But I'm gonna try to sound like what Mother Redding told it to us, because it was very comical about what she thought about it. Now, we don't want you to think the same thing she thought, so that's why I'm explaining it. She came home from church after Annual Women's Day, and she told her mother, she said, "Mama, do you know what those ladies did at Great Holy Temple today?" She said, "No, Kim, what did they do?" She said, "Let me tell you, they acted up. They did the singing, they did the usher board, and they even took the money." And after that, they preached. And they didn't let poor Elder Sutton do nothing. And those men didn't even, they were his friends, they didn't say a word. And so she said, "Well, let me explain." She said, "Mama, I ain't done." She said, "And when they got done doing that, they went down in the bed and made them men fix their food." And she said, "You know, that was a shame." And she said, well, Kim, that was annual. She said, I don't know what day it was, but I know they acted ugly. So we not going to act ugly today. We're going to be good. And Pastor Ross, you don't have to worry. Next Sunday, Lord delay is coming. We ain't taking over. You can be right back up there next Sunday. Thank you.
Praise the Lord. Yes, of a truth. I remember Sister Kim. She sure did. She said the women just took over. And surely today all we're doing is giving our pastor a little rest. We thank him so much for this opportunity. Glad for Mother Winters being here with us today. Also, amen, Deacon Winters. People of God, I can't name all of our guests today, but I am so glad to see y'all. Some of y'all I haven't seen since this whole pandemic started. You know, it just feel good to see the people of God, don't it? Just feel good. We've been seeing y'all on Facebook and stuff and on the phone, but we're glad to see your faces today worshiping with us in this great Women's Day service. We're going to move on, and one of the great traditions of the Greater Holy Temple Women's Day is that we honor and spotlight a woman of the year. We're going to go forth at this time, and we're going to receive the committee and those that are in charge of this particular part of the service, and we are going to receive the Woman of the Year Award. Say amen for the committee.
Amen. We praise the Lord for the service thus far. We give honor to God and to our pastor and first lady, for everyone that's here on today. Trying to make sure we're here. To everyone that's here on today, we just thank the Lord for our great old holy temple, Woman of the Year, and how we thank this young lady for her service, for her faithfulness, for her prayer life, how she's been an encourager. She is saved and sanctified and filled with the Holy Ghost. She is a member of the wellness. She participated in our Tuesday night services, bringing the word. She participated in our Sunday school teaching, our outreach in the park. She's very faithful, and she always have a yes in her spirit. And we thank the Lord for her, and she's even lately has conducted some of our praise service. And I think she may know who she is right now. As she look around, we're thankful for our family that's here. So we ask you to receive our 2021 Woman of the Year, Missionary Marie Meadows. She is receiving a plaque. Amen. With that recognition, a bag of goodies, which we had some help in knowing what to pick. Of the year, 2021 Missionary Marie Meadows, Woman of the Year. family, they came to be with her on today.
I just appreciate you all. Thank you so much. I'm just very appreciative, and I love you guys, and I thank the Lord for this honor. But, you know, all I do to the glory of God. It's all for Him, and we're all His servants, and I just appreciate you. Thank you so much for this honor. I appreciate you all. Love you. Love you, Pastor. Love you all.
Really having a problem with this mic there. Okay. Isn't that wonderful? Thank God. What a blessing to be honored and to be esteemed by your peers. I've said what she said. It is a tremendous honor. So such a humbling experience to be considered and to be appreciated for what you do. And we thank God. All of these women at Greater Holy Temple are some phenomenal women. But we just have this opportunity once a year that we spotlight. Sometimes there are some things that just stand out. Sometimes there are some things that just really strike your attention. There's some things and sometimes things that people do that really, really make a tremendous impact. And they're not doing it, you know, to show you, but they're just doing it to the glory of God. We thank God for our own missionary ward. Y'all know I didn't know because I pointed out all these wards that are here. No wonder y'all here. Glad for you. Glad for you. Don't make this your last time. But we're so glad for all of those aunts. And certainly they have a heritage here in this church. Amen. They have a heritage here. And we're glad for them and for our own Sister Meadows, who is working so beautifully in this vineyard. We're going to move on. And we praise God for this committee and for this great selection of our Woman of the Year. We're going to move on. We've got some topic speakers today. We've got a wonderful, wonderful topic today. Works of a holy woman's hands. Oh, I tell you what, and I thank God because, you know, Solomon talked about it, and he said, you know, let her works praise her in the gates, the wonderful works that she does. And we thank God for our women, how God has given us a great work. And we thank God for those who are excited about that work, who get busy and doing the things that their hands find to do. And we're so glad. We've got some topic speakers that are going to be coming at this time. Our own Sister Sharon Causey. And after her will be Sister Kimberly Kiner. Now, these women don't call themselves missionary. Don't fool yourself. They got something to say. And so we appreciate them. They're coming in that order. Let's receive them.
Praise the Lord, saints. I honor the Lord on today. That's ahead of my life. And thank the Lord for being baptized and filled with the Holy Ghost. I thank God for my pastor and my first lady. And even to our visitor guests on today, Evangelist Hackworth and her husband on today, her companion on today. I just thank God for being here and for the opportunity to stand before you on today. I'm not one that like to be in the spotlight. I like to kind of be in the background. But I pray and ask God to use me as his vessel. Just do what he needs to do for me in my life. And I thank God for him just blessing me on last week for the healing in my body. I tell you what, I came in here last Sunday. Pastor First Lady, I couldn't even walk. My feet hurts me so bad. I just couldn't even take a step last week. But I thank God that I was able to do my job, rehearsing and stuff. But when I left here, I felt good in my sanctified soul. And I give God the praise for it on today. Topic for today is the work of a holy woman's hands. We go to Acts 36 and 41. And there was a joker, if I'm pronouncing that right, a certain disciple named Tabitha, which by interpret is called Dorcas. And this woman was full of good work and aim deeds, which she did. And as it came to pass in those days that she was sick and dying, when they had washed, they laid her in an upper chamber. As Lydia was nigh to Jupiter, and the disciple had heard that Peter was there, they sent unto him two men, desiring him that he would not delay to come. Then Peter rose and went with them. When he came, they brought him into the upper chamber, and all the widows stood by him weeping, and showing the coat and garment which Dorcas made while she was with them. But Peter put them all forth and kneeled down and prayed. Turning him to the body, said, "Tabitha, arise." And she opened her eyes, and when she saw Peter, she sat up. And he gave her his hands and lifted her up. And when he had called the saints and the widows, proceeded her life. Dorcas known as Tabitha. Why the Bible says nothing of her physical beauty. She was also called a disciple of Jesus, one who learned from him, part of the inner circle in the early churches. Dorcas served the Lord, and because of that, he gave her favor with the people. Her life was one spent in serving those who was less fortunate. She was committed to God's work and gave to the poor at all times. She also was known for her charity and generous person who sowed. You know, I noticed that a lot of our saints here at the church, they do we have quite a few saints here that sow and they knit and do different things, and they do whatever their hands find to do. Amen. You know, I dab a little bit in sewing, you know, but, you know, not really great at it, but I do a little bit of it. I was trying to learn how to knit and stuff, but I just couldn't get the hang of that one yet. But, let me see. And when the widows heard of her passing away, they wasn't happy. They was really upset. And during the time, then they cleaned her up and then, you know, laid her in the chamber. And then they heard that Peter was nearby. And then they sent out the two men to bring Peter back. And when Peter got there, and then he said to her, they showed Peter that she was there, and then they was upset, showing the love for the dead. And then they heard of Peter being close by, and they sent for him two men. When Peter got there, the widow showed Peter the garment that she had made for the poor, and the evidence of her life is that for all to see. Peter was touched by the grief. Then he turned to Tabitha's body, drawing on the source of power that Jesus had. Peter put out his hand to her and commanded her to get up. Tabitha got up, and all her friends came outside to see with their own eyes what had happened. And because of this great woman, many people believed in the Lord. Darkness restored to light. She returned to her friends and her community. You know, I was thinking, my father always said to me, no matter how people treat you, you always treat people kind and good. He also said that, you know, when you treat people good and kind, and your work here on this earth will show that. When you leave here, you know, growing up as a child, I did not always understood what my father meant by that. My father was a deacon in the church, and that's, he loved that, and he also was an usher in the church. And he said, daughter, no matter what people do to you, you keep on loving them and treat them with respect and treat them well. And when you leave this earth, your life gonna speak for itself. And I remember the day when my father passed away and the day that we laid him to rest. I tell you, saints, there was no room for nobody to sit. And as we was heading to the cemetery, you see people on every side of the street. As each time we would go to a different street, people would salute, because my father served 30 years in the Army. And because the life that he lived, it showed that people loved him. And I thank God for that. And I'm trying to live my life just like that. Even though people hurt me, I still try to be good and kind to them. But you know, sometimes you wonder, why do people do what they do? But I goes back and remember what my father said, no matter how people treat you, you still treat them with loving kindness. And see, that's what Dorcas did. She always took care of her community, excuse me. She done whatever her hands would allow her to do. And in my conclusion, what we can learn from Dorcas' life is that you will be remembered for the things you did. Most when you can't help yourself, the people will help you. Keep on doing good for others, and it will pay off in the end. Y'all pray for me.
God bless you. Good afternoon to everyone. First, I want to give honor to my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. I thank him for blessing me. He is a wonderful God. I can't tell it all. But I do give honor to our own Pastor Ross and his lovely wife, Lady Ross, and to our distinguished guest, Superintendent Hackworth, and his lovely wife, our speaker, Lady Evangelist Kina Hackworth. And to all the wonderful women here in church today, and to our Woman of the Year, Missionary Meadows, who I can say has personally prayed for me with me and was even with me when I got the news that my mother had been given up by the doctors. She was there to sit with my sister when she found out. And so I just thank God for the fact that I'm living with women who have holy hands. And I only have a few minutes, but I just thank God for when I read the story, how I thought about a time where I was outside just a few weeks ago, and I saw a beautiful pot of flowers, and the flowers were so beautiful, but there was this big brown branch that had brown leaves and brown flowers that were all dried up and dead. And I thought, ooh, that just looks horrible. I gotta yank that down. And because it was a whole bunch of them. It was unbelievable. And so I went up there and I yanked it down. And in my hand, I saw at the bottom, there were beautiful flowers at the bottom. And I thought, how in the world could these pretty, juicy looking flowers be on this big old dead branch? I took another look, and the stem, it was still green. And I thought, if I had known this stem was still alive, I would not have yanked it down. But I'm not a florist. I'm not good at all of that. So I foolishly yanked it out. But there was still life in there. I should have just carefully taken off the dead leaves and flowers instead of just yanking it all off, because there's still life there. And it let me know, I believe the Lord was speaking to me that day, don't be so quick to yank out the things that don't look great in my life right now. Just carefully take another look. There may be some life still there. And I thank God that the women and men that were there with Sister Dorcas after she had been laid in the chamber, I'm glad somebody realized there's still some life there, possibility of life. And if they didn't believe that, they wouldn't have sent for Peter. And I thank God somebody of some of the disciples sent for Peter to get her some help. It is just didn't leave Sister Dorcas for dead, that they actually brought her to life by believing and praying, and the widows were crying, and they were showing Peter her beautiful garments because they valued the contributions that she had made. And when they were weeping, it shows us that they didn't just value her works, but they valued her and they loved her. So we have some beautiful works that we can do as women and men of God. One of the things we want to do is we want to be careful. And then we also, because we can do great works with our hands, but we can also do some destroying with our hands. And we want to be careful that we don't go that way with our works, but just keep it on the positive, doing the right things with our hands. God bless you, saints. I love you.
We have shared so beautifully that word. Oh, yes. And we just appreciate them. We thank God. Want to thank God for Mother Alma Hill. Just want to thank God for her being here, because this time last week we got word she was in the hospital. Amen. And today she walked in here. Yes. Thank God. Yes. We praise God. We got word even in our service on last Sunday that Sister Hill was in the hospital, but the Lord has blessed her and she is here today. Don't look like she's been sick. We thank God. She don't look like what she's been through. God has blessed her again and raised her up, and we are so blessed. We're thanking God for our service, and we surely had a good time. Thank God for all of our guests and everybody who has been with us all through this service. We've had, like I said, some of you have been with us from the beginning when we danced at the beginning of the service. We, you know, might have got a little mixed up, but we danced at the beginning. You know, we got, you know, I told them, Sister Hackworth, you know, most of the time we dance later on. You know, we dance late, but this time we got excited, we got confused, and we danced at the beginning. Some of y'all didn't miss, y'all missed out on the first dance, but we're gonna have another one after a while. And all those that missed out on the first round, y'all can get in on the next round. Hallelujah. Thank God. Oh, yes. We thank God today for how the Lord is blessed. Glad to see Grace back there. I just can't, you know what? I just have to keep, you know, thanking God for different ones. We prayed for her, different ones that are among us. And she's not the only one, but I'm just looking at the miracle of God. Listen, when you have presented a life before the Lord, we don't think it robbery to just ask God to work some miracles for us. When you presented a life before him, you qualified to ask him for some miracles. Hallelujah. And I thank God for that woman of God sitting right there. We're so glad for her. But at this time, I'm getting ready to sit down for real. I'm going to sit down. We're going to be in the hands of our first lady at this time, because she's going to come to introduce our speaker. Say amen. Give mother a mic. We got another mic over there. Amen. Can we give God a shout out today? Can we say hallelujah? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God. We thank God. Amen. We thank God for this wonderful Women's Day worship service on this afternoon. And I know that I have been blessed. Have you been blessed? Amen. Amen. I have been blessed. I've enjoyed the speakers and amen, the praise and worship. I've enjoyed everyone that has been on the program. I do give honor to God. Amen. To my pastor. Amen. Pastor Ross. Amen. You can clap for him. Yes, amen. Amen. We were blessed to serve, to have our 33rd anniversary. Amen. On last weekend. Amen. We praise God. Amen. We thank God for our guest on today. We thank God for our own administrative assistant, Superintendent Hackworth. Amen. As well as our speaker of the hour, amen, national evangelist, Lady Kina Hackworth. Amen. Amen. And I do give honor to our church mother, Mother Kane.
amen, as well as our own district missionary and our mother Harris, amen, and to our elders, to our ministers, to missionaries, and to all of the saints of God, and especially to our woman of the year, amen, missionary Marie Meadows. Amen, 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 and you do deserve it, amen. I praise God for her, amen, a praying woman, amen, and I thank God for her. And I know I'm up here to introduce our speaker on this afternoon, and I have known Lady Hackworth for, man, we were little girls. I don't know, maybe about 5 or 6 years old that we have been knowing each other. And I remember when I had my first encounter with her, she was already on fire for the Lord. And we did good honor to her mother as well. Amen. Amen, Mother Winters. Amen. And I saw Deacon Winters here too. Amen. Her parents. And yes. Amen. And but I remember seeing her at that young age, and she was just on fire. She was a little missionary, even at 5 or 6 years old. And how that she never lost that burning, but how that she kept on, you know, in the Lord, and how the Lord continued to bless her to where she is right now. Amen. And we praise God for her. And I'm going to read her bio here. And this is National Evangelist Keena Hackworth, raised in the Church of God in Christ under the leadership of Bishop Donald L. Alford Sr. She is the daughter of Deacon Benny and District Missionary Mary Winters. She is the eldest of one sibling. Evangelist Hackworth's heart belongs to Second Administrative Assistant William C. Hackworth Sr., who is her husband, covering pastor, and superintendent. She is the mother of three children whom she adores very much, Anthony R. Fluker, Lucinda Fluker, McDaniels, and Mia Fluker. Three adorable grandsons, Trey Fluker, Anthony L. McDaniels, and Jaden McDaniels, and one granddaughter, Zaya Chantel McDaniels. Evangelist Hackworth serves as the First Lady of the Unity Church of God in Christ, located in Elkhart, Indiana, and is the First Lady of the Solid Rock District, where she supports the ministry wholeheartedly. Evangelist Hackworth is a national appointed licensed evangelist missionary with the Church of God in Christ and in good standing. Evangelist is faithful to the historic First Ecclesiastical Jurisdiction of Indiana, Bishop Carl J. Steen Jr., jurisdictional bishop, jurisdictional supervisor is Mother Darlene Bartlett Stone. Evangelist Hackworth is author and writer of a book that God has favored. This book is of her personal testimony and is titled The Will to Live. This book is of God sustaining her life through tragedy. My message is that souls will be saved and filled in this last day. Amen. Again, we thank God for Evangelist Hackworth, and we're going to ask you just to raise your right hand and receive Evangelist Keena Hackworth. Amen. Amen.
Come on, come on, come on, give him a hand praise. Come on, come on, I come to give him some more praise. He is worthy. Come on, he's worthy of the praise. Come on, I don't know what you come to do, but I come to lift up the name of Jesus. Why? Because he's been real good to me. He's been better to me than I've been to myself. Come on, give him some praise. Come on, give him some praise. It was not the alarm clock that woke us up this morning. It was not the voice of a loved one that woke us up this morning. But it was God that breathed the breath of life into us and told us to live one more day. Come on, we were created for praise. Oh, come on, God is walking up and down. He's coming down your aisle. Whatever you need, God's got it for you on this afternoon. Whatever you've been praying about, God's got it on this afternoon. Come on, just reach up and grab it. Just reach up and grab it. Has it been good to you? Has it been-
just be myself.
Conviction, God. Let us not leave out of here the same way we came. God, we just say thank you, Jesus. We 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 say thank you, Jesus. Even when we don't understand, God, we say thank you, Jesus. We say thank you, Jesus. Come on, people of God, and say thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Give your name the praise. Let every heart say thank God. Come on, thank God. Amen. Come on and give him a hand clap as you take your seat. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on, come on, come on. Well, I come to give him some more praise. Missionary Harris says y'all shouted before I got in the room. Hallelujah. But I keep a little dance with me. simply because the doctor said I wouldn't be able to do that. And the enemy thought he stole my dance. You see, I still got that metal plate in here, but I still got a dance too. Above a whisper, every bone broken except for two, hit head on by a drunk driver. But oh, when man said she would not live or may not live, God said not so. He said way back then, I believe I'll give her the will to live. Hallelujah. I'm so excited to be here on this afternoon. I'm just grateful to God that he woke me up this morning. I say that often. Because when you've been at the doors of death, you value waking up. Because then you're always left with the thought, there's a possibility I just might not wake up in the morning. But when you wake up and you're able to look outside and you say, God, I thank you, because I realize somebody didn't get up this morning. Somebody slept on into eternity. I don't know what the day holds, but as for me, I'm going to give you praise. Hallelujah. I give honor to Pastor and Lady Ross, to my own wonderful companion, Administrator W.C. Hackworth Sr. Amen. Amen. God has allowed him to come through eye surgery, and we thank God. I thank God for Mother Kane on this afternoon. Amen. Amen. I thank God, and my mind had been heavily on Mother Kane, and I said, God, I thank you for Mother Kane. I remember as a little girl. Amen. I've been in church all my life, and I so often reminisce about District Number 2. Amen. Some of y'all may not know about District Number 2, but those were the real church days. Mother Pam, I was a little girl, but I remember the night you got saved. Amen. But I remember Mother Kane. Amen. And Mother Kane has been an integral part of my life, all of my church life since she came into the church.
Amen. Since she's been up in those mature years of encouraging me. And it's good when you can just have somebody whisper an encouraging word to you every now and then to let you know that they love you and that they're praying for you. And so I thank God for Mother Kane. I thank God for District Missionary Harris, amen, on this afternoon, for my own District Missionary Holiday and my own mother, District Missionary Winters, and also my dad, amen. And to the Unity Church family, amen. And the Greater Holy Temple women, come on and make some noise. Amen, amen. And also to District Missionary Shante Mack Taylor, amen, amen. And Sister Jennifer, all the way here, amen. Wave your hand, Sister Jennifer, amen. Amen. It was so humorous. I shared with my husband, Sister Jennifer, and I talked, and she said, I got a surprise for you, but I just can't hold it. I'm going to be there at Great Old. I told my husband, and we laughed. I said, she ruined her own surprise. But I love, love, love Sister Jennifer. She is a jewel. Amen. Let's give her a hand. Sister Jennifer is a jewel. Amen. And again, I want to thank Pastor Ross and to Lady Ross that are doing a great work. A great work. Hallelujah. Amen. And on yesterday, I was able to watch a little bit, catch a little bit via Facebook. Amen. So I just praise God for the work that they do in the vineyard. Somebody say no lack. No lack. Come on, say it with your voice of authority. No lack. There'll be no lack in my home. There'll be no lack on my job. There'll be no lack in my family. There'll be no lack in my finances. Do y'all hear what I'm saying? There'll be no lack in my health. How many of you know that there'll be no lack? That's not part of the message, but I tell people everywhere I go, no lack. I need y'all to catch that. Somebody need to take that back home. No lack. Take it back to Elkhart. Take it back to Michigan. Wherever you're from, take it back to Indianapolis. No lack in my home. No lack on my job. No lack in my family. No lack in my finances. No lack in my health. I speak wealth. I speak healing. There shall be no lack. Everything attached to me shall win because I'm a winner and I'm speaking no lack. Give the Lord a hand praise. No lack. The Lord gave that to me at the beginning of the year, and I take it everywhere I go. No lack, no matter what it looks like. Because the enemy will twist things around. Sometimes we get caught up on what it looks like, but there shall be no lack. Let's go to our theme scripture quickly. Amen. And somebody say, just work. Come on, say, just work. Amen. Amen. I see Sister Parham back there. But I'm going to go ahead. I'm sorry. All right. Sister Parham, go ahead and read for us. Acts 9, 36 through 41. Amen. We thank God for the reading of his word, and we certainly want to acknowledge the elder of our house, Elder Parham. Amen. Here this passage tells us, Tabitha called Dorcas in Greek,
She was known for her works and acts of charity. It says she was full of good works and alms deeds. Now remember in the book of Acts, there was a man who was unable to walk and unable to work. The story tells that someone carried him to sit outside of the temple of the gate called Beautiful to beg for people to give alms to him. This is one of the good works Sister Tabitha did. She was concerned and cared about those who could not do for themselves and those who were in need. This is what her alms deeds was about. She was a giving person who sold for others and gave to the needy. Study says that she may have been a widow, but the Bible does not define if she was a widow, married, or single. But what is understood is she was a disciple of Jesus. She was a follower of Christ. Be careful and be conscious of who you follow. Sister Tabitha was full of good works. What is good works? And I stress full, because women are full of creativity. Oh, we may not have degrees for what all we can do, but as I say, we can get the job done. I tell my husband so often, I'm a doctor, I just don't have a degree. I could work out what's wrong with you, I just don't have a degree. So I just tell him, just call me Dr. Hackworth. Good means that which is by its nature pleasing, that is pleasing to God, that which is upright and honorable in his sight. So in this, with understanding, every saint, this is for the men too, needs to remember a vital fact about good works. Christ is the root. Good works are the fruit. Let me say that again. Christ is the root. Good works are the fruit. In our YPWW lesson, Paul admonished the saints to be fruitful in every assignment. In other words, your works ought to produce fruit. Hallelujah. Good works are our witness to the unsaved. Matthew 5:16 says, let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. Let me say that again. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify the Father which is in heaven. Good works goes beyond just good deeds. But your attitude and your conduct among your co-workers, loving everyone, not just reading and believing the word of God, but living it. There's a signature conduct that the world should see in every true believer, every true Christian, every true saint. And one of the things ought to be our love and kindness. The song says they'll know we are Christians by our love. We're talking about good works. Women whose holy hands are at work is not concerned with validation. They don't need validation, but holy hands at work do get attention. Holy hands get a response. Holy hands are willing to be used, however, whenever, and wherever. Understand, sisters, this is where the saying fits. It's not about who you are, but whose you are. The works that you do is not about you. Ecclesiastes 9:10 says, whatsoever thy hand findeth to do, do it with thy might, for there is no work, nor device, nor knowledge, nor wisdom in the grave whither thou goest. John 9:4 says, I must work the works of him that has sent me while it is day. The night cometh when no man can work. Somebody say, just work. Problem is, people want to be used on condition. They want to be used with terms.
want to be used according to their timing. They want to be used if the right person has asked them. You know what to do, you know how to do, you know where to do, but you won't do. All right. My God. Hallelujah. We need women that are willing to be used. We'll work without being asked. You don't have to call them. They just show up. The Bible lets us know that Dorcas just showed up. Sometimes silently and sometimes they knew that she was coming. But however the fact, she was there where a need was, she was there. Come on and clap your hands right there. I remember as a little girl when the saints would hear about another saint being ill. Again, this was district number 2 days when my grandmother was living. And I remember Mother Wiley. I remember Mother Jordan. I remember Mother Malone and my grandmother. And, of course, Mother O.C. Scott and Mother Borders. When they would hear about a saint being sick or in need, they would just show up. There was a lot of times my grandmother drugged me to somebody's house for family prayer. Come on, somebody. They would go in their house and the person wouldn't know they was coming, but they said, we come to have Bible study in your house because the marriage just wasn't right, but we come to bring Jesus up in here. Hallelujah. It was them days when the mothers for real was teaching the younger women how to live holy, how to stay saved, how to treat your unsaved husband. It was then, are we talking about holy hands? It was those days where they were yet going to the sick and laying hands on them. They didn't question, they just did. It was those days they were taking bags of food to maybe somebody's house that didn't quite have enough to make ends meet. It was those days that they was all putting the little money they had in a pot to help somebody pay the light bill. Come on, somebody, anybody know what I'm talking about? Holy hands. Women are full with gifts and talents, but their hands are idle. Let me just stop right there. I hear the Holy Ghost speaking. Hands are idle because we don't want to share with the next person what we know. Do you know when you leave off the scene, we left with what we have now? People trying to understand how to navigate through this thing. But you see, back then, my generation wasn't quite listening as closely as we should have. Because again, those older saints was trying to tell us there's a dark day coming and you better be ready. Oh, I remember them teaching. There'll be a day when you won't be able to go into the house of the Lord. You better cherish this time now. There'll be a day, they said, a dark day, a Noah day. Come on, somebody. And if you're not ready, you'll be lost in it. Hallelujah. But now hands are idle. And you got everybody trying to figure out how to do, what to do, and when to do. Hallelujah. I know that this younger generation don't really want to quite listen the way we did, but we still got a job to do. We still got work to do. We still got to figure out how to tell them anyhow. Even though it may look like it's falling on deaf ears, we yet got to tell them. Because every one of us was stubborn somewhere along the way, but somebody kept on knocking on our door until we got the picture, until we took hold of what they were trying to tell us. It's because somebody didn't give up on me. It's why I'm here today. Somebody didn't give up. Somebody prayed for you. Somebody didn't turn their back on you. Somebody didn't throw in the towel on you. Somebody didn't leave you behind. Everybody wasn't talking about you. Everybody wasn't lying on you. But you turned your attention to those that didn't care about you. And while you turned your attention that way, somebody was over here in your clap and cheer corner, clapping for you, praying for you, trying to tell you you can make it. The works of a woman's holy hand just work. If I never get accolades, I'm going to keep on working. Somebody say, just work. I came to encourage you on this afternoon to tell you to just work. Come on, look over at somebody and tell them, just work. Come on, just work. Just work. You're turning your attention the wrong way. They don't notice what I'm doing. I'm out there all the time and I'm trying to do this and that and nobody is noticing me but just work. Nobody is giving me the pat on my back I need but just work. Nobody is giving me the opportunity but just work. You're not always going to be on the front row. You're not always going to be front and center. But wherever I'm at in the crowd, I just want to be named among them that I'm working. Keep on praying. Keep on praying. Keep coming to prayer meeting. Keep getting on the prayer call line. Keep on praying. You know that God has given you a spirit of prayer. You know that he's given you a gift of praying for others. Don't worry about if you're not the prayer captain, you're not the prayer leader. I need your prayers. Keep praying. Hallelujah. Keep on encouraging one another. Hallelujah. Don't nobody always have to see that you're patting somebody on the back, but just keep on encouraging them. Keep letting your light shine in the community. Hallelujah. What are they out in the park for? And nobody's coming to the church, but make sure your light is shining because God needs to see your fruits. Show up for each other. It's not about she's my friend. It's not about, well, I just know her a little bit, but show up, keep working. Lend a helping hand. Be willing to go out of your comfort zone. Well, I really don't do that for other people. Well, if God has given you the gift and the talent, don't let it go dormant, but just use it wherever it's needed and use it beyond. Just think if Dorcas wouldn't have used her gifts, then nobody would have cared once she died, but they knew that they needed her. You ought to be a person that's needed and people need you. Come on and clap your hands. Just work. Somebody say just work. Remember, it's not about the title or position. It's not about name or control, but your willingness to just work. It's not about what's in it for you. It's not about what you'll gain. Just work. It's not about who's in the park, who's already been to visit the sick, who's helping the praise team. But I just want to tell you, just work. Hallelujah. Your attitude ought to be, I'm here because I'm needed. I'm here because there's a dying world out there. I'm keep on working because we got the lost we need to reach. Souls yet need to be saved. I don't know about you, but I got some family members that yet need to be saved. I may not be able to reach them, but you might be able to reach them. Just keep on working until the day is done. Keep letting your light shine. Everything that God has given to you, you ought to use it as unto God. Just work, because only what you do for Christ, it will last. That's what I wanted to tell you about Sister Dorcas, because at the end, only what she did for Christ, just work. Somebody say just work. Just work. I'm getting ready to close. The Bible says that Tabitha got sick and died. Disciples had heard that Peter was there, and they sent for him. When Peter got there, they began to show him all the works of Tabitha. Peter cleared the room and said, Tabitha, arise. And she opened her eyes. And when she saw Peter, she sat up. When you begin to work, the enemy will take notice. Everything has got to go. Everything will be made right when you begin to work with the right attitude, the right frame of mind. Just work. It's going to pay off. If you never get a plaque with your name on it, if you never get a crown, I call come to tell you, you got a crown of life waiting on you. You got a robe of righteousness waiting on you. Just work, make it count for something down here. Prayer warriors, keep on working. Intercessors, keep on working. Let's go. We got work to do. Let's keep on moving. We got work to do. I got so much that God has shown me. You got work to do. Don't let the enemy destroy you. Don't let the enemy mess you up. Don't let the enemy come to your mind. Work, work, work. You got work. You got work to do. Lord, use me for your servant. Lord, use me. Use me. You got work. You got work. Work to do. Keep on, keep singing, you got work to do. Keep on, keep preaching, you got work to do. Keep on, keep teaching, you got work to do. Yeah, 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 yeah. Keep on, laying hands, you got work to do. Keep on. You got work to do. Keep on talking to the children. You got work to do. Just work. Just work. Just work. Just work. Just work. Just work.
Yeah.
but you withdraw back. I don't think it'll be pretty enough. I don't really know if they want it, but be fruitful in how God has blessed your hands. Stop drawing back. Idle hands. God tells you to do something, and you lay idle. You're waiting on the first lady to assign you. You got idle hands. When she assigns you, those are her fruits. But where are your fruits? Y'all better understand it. When she tells you what to do, and she sends you out to do what she's assigned you, those are her fruits. I know y'all thought those were your fruits. Those are her fruits. You offer her vine. Them her apples she dropping. Those are her peaches she dropping. Why? Because they say, oh, those are greater holy temple women. But what you doing without assignment? When you go to the grocery store and somebody don't have quite enough money, they don't know you as a greater holy temple woman. But they know you as that lady, and they won't forget the kind deed. They won't forget the Dorcas that's down in you. They won't forget the Sister Tabitha that's down in you. They won't forget the Marion that you are. Oh! Just work. Just work. These are your fruits then. These are your fruits. These are your fruits. Love and kindness, peace and long-suffering. These are your fruits. But you can't tell me about long-suffering, the fruit of your spirit, if you've never been through it, if you didn't stay in your suffering, if you didn't exemplify peace, if you didn't show no love. You can't tell me how to have love if you're getting mad on your job. You can't tell me how to have peace if you can't get along with your family members. You can't tell me how to stay in it and not backslide and not throw in the towel if every time trouble comes your way, you get mad and leave church. You put God on pause. You say, I'll be back when things get better. Every time you get sick, you say, I'm staying home. But they taught me, Mother Cain, Mother Harris, Mama, y'all taught me that this is the same. Just work. Just work. Just work. Just work. Don't nobody up in here ever notice your work. God does. Somebody say, just work. Just work. Come on, everybody standing. Just work. Just work. Just work. Just work. Just work. Come on and begin to clap your hands. Come on. Ask God to restore those gifts and talents back in you. I can't lay hands on you one by one. But come on, just begin to praise God and tell him to begin to restore those gifts in you, to give you a second chance to use you. Lord, use me for your service. Lord, use you for my service. Lord, use me. Yes, sir. Come on and praise him. Lord, use me for your service. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. God, let my loving kindness get me on the inside. Let my light shine. Helen, yeah. Helen, yeah. Helen, yeah. Share your wisdom. Share your knowledge. It's done for you. Yes! 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 Do it again, God. Do it again, God. Do it again, God. Do it again, God. Do it, God. For your glory. Do it, God. For your glory. Do it, God. For your glory. God's not finished. He's not done with you. Yes! Yes! You've been silent long enough. You've been in a corner long enough to tell your story. Tell your story. Yes. 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 Tell your story. Yes. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, God. Yes, God. Yes, God. God. Come on, yes, God. Oh, glory. Yes, God. Yes, God. Come on, do it, God. 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 Come on, come on, come on. 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 Oh. 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 Come on. Shaka. Canada Boshata. Oh, Canada Boshata. Canada Boshata. Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, do it, God. Restore, God. Bring it back to life, God. Oh, bring back to life, God. Wake up the spirit man in its fullness. Wake it up in the fullness. Wake it up in the fullness. How? How? Wake it up in the fullness. How? Wake it up in the fullness. Yes, God. Yes, God. Yes, God. Yes, God. Yes, God. Yes, God. Yes, God.
Yeah! You better come get yours. Thank you.
Come on, clap your hands. His daughter says she want to be saved. Come on, clap your hands and celebrate her.
Hi, I'm Sarita Turner, a member of Greater Holy Temple. Ladies, it's that time of year again for our Women's Day program, August 22nd, 2021 at 2 p.m. Our speaker this year is National Evangelist Lady Kina Hackworth. Our colors this year are white with shades of purple accessories. And if you would like to be a blessing to us, you can go to our website at myghtchurch.com, and we are located at 710 Napoleon. Keep the date, August 22nd, 2021. Hope to see you there.